So we'll get started. Slovakia, what? Welcome back to the GeoGuessr video. In today's video, we're going to do something a little bit different. And before we go, explain what's going on in this video, a little new series concept, hope you had a great Christmas. And I was going to actually record a video on Merry Lord just before Christmas, but I didn't really have time to. So I'm recording this on Boxing Day, so this will be the day after. So yeah, hope you had a great Christmas. And as I said, we're going to start off today's video with a new, kind of new mini series concept. Just for something I just thought at the top of my head. So yeah, basically I want to kind of find out in GeoGuessr what's my strongest continent and what's my weakest continent. And so I thought it'd be a good idea to play each continental map on the game. So Europe, North America, South America, Africa, Asia, and I think Oceania as well. And basically I'll play three rounds of no moving, three games of no moving, 1 minute 30 each round probably, to give a time limit because I don't want to spend forever basically on each round. And after each game I'll total up the scores, and then I'm basically going to find an average. So so after three games I'll find the average score for each continent, and then I'll do that for each continent, and then we'll find out at the end which is my strongest continent, judging off the three games I played, and which is the weakest continent. Obviously, there's luck involved as well in terms of what rounds we'll get on each map and everything, but I thought it'd be just a cool idea to do. So if you do go to like this video, make sure you drop a like, that'd be appreciated. And also, as I said, if you think this is a good series idea, let me know. And I thought it would make sense to start off with Europe in this video. Obviously, a few things that might be a bit skewed. For example, the points, how the points work in these continental maps is different, because obviously you're working with a smaller space, so it will be harsher with your scores. So maybe if I get like 15, I'll just have 15k. Technically, that's a decent score. In all things considered, but yeah, I think we'll have to get some decent, really good guesses in to try and boost up my score if I really want to get that high. Also, not wearing a hoodie this video. I know, I usually wear hoodies, don't I? But yeah, bit of a sort of change up this video. And also, I'm not home either, judging by the slightly poorer lighting. Apologies for that, but I don't think it's too bad today. So anyway, introduction over. It's been a long introduction. Let's get into the first game. And so we're going to do, I don't usually play with the time limit to be honest, but we'll give this a go. I think 1 minute 30 is more, I think that's decent for each round. And as I said, I'll add up the scores in each game, and then I'll make an average of it. So yeah, let's get into the first game, and hopefully my European skills today are pretty good. Let's get into it. All right, need to get in the zone here, because I'm kind of testing my knowledge here and testing my skills, and I don't want to do the silly errors. So let's go. Right, so what we got here, so this looks French. I'm not going to try and pronounce it because I feel like my pronunciations aren't quite on point today. Let's have a look at what we got. It should be France. I mean, we don't have any red tints in number plates, and it won't be Belgium. So yeah, it looks like France to me. Couldn't really tell you where. We don't have a lot to go off. Looks a bit more northern than anything really, I guess, because it doesn't look too dissimilar from Britain, but it does at the same time. This should be, I can't really make it anything on the number plates, but those look like standard French number plates. It would help actually if I found like one on with blue strip on the right, or maybe like a yellow plate. You do see those in France as well, but I'm not sure really where to go, because I said the points are harsher on these on these continental maps, because you're working with a smaller space. So just gonna make sure we're not gonna get any more clues on the sign. Maybe it's too blurry. So I would say it looks a bit more northern, but it doesn't look like Paris. I reckon Tours is a decent place to go. Let's see if oh, it was Belgium. Okay, not a great start. It didn't look like Belgium to me. Those didn't look like Belgian plates at all. Can we see the red tint? We can't, to be fair. That's unlucky. We couldn't see any red tint on number plates. So maybe they weren't Belgian, or that wasn't a Belgian plate there. Yeah, bit of a bummer to start off with, but not a bad guess. Can forgive me for going France there. Right. Don't have any riffs, I don't think. Judging off first glance, Italy. Okay, it is Italy. Do you have a narrow? Yeah, we have a narrow plate there. That's good. So right, so this should be quite far south. Very, very Mediterranean looking. Well, those plates are a little bit hard to make out, but yeah, Italy. If I had to guess, I'd probably even say on Sicily here. Because it looks that far south to me. Looks a bit like Malta as well. So I'll probably well guess Sicily. Or will I? Or is it just really far south on the mainland? I'll guess Messina. Because it's a little bit of a hedge in case it is a bit further up. I don't think we're going to get more clues. So let's try and let's go there. It was Malta. God, okay, I've had a few misses so far. Not a great start. I've been picking up in the next game or maybe in the next round. That, again, was a bait by the plates. So the plates really baited me so far. I did think it looked a bit weird, but I just thought with that narrow plate at the front there, I just thought maybe it is blue here. It's just harder to see. But yeah, Malta. It doesn't make sense with the architecture. I just thought, since I saw an Italian plate, I just thought it'd be like Sicily or something. I've been baited. I've been baited again there. Maybe I should have paid more attention to the number of plates on the whole rather than that one. But yeah, next round, not terrible, not terrible. It's a round I probably should be getting though. So yeah, maybe I have a good title. If the number plates keep baiting me, maybe I have a decent title here for the video. Right. These bollards remind me of like Austria, Slovenia, that sort of area, but it might not be. I know they belong in those two countries. It could also be Serbia, I think. It looks more like Serbia to me. Like mountainous part of Serbia, but I'm stuck between Serbia and Slovenia here. I don't think it's Austria. Something's telling me it's not. I mean, it probably is not even me. Because it's quite mountainous here, but it doesn't really remind me of the Austrian mountains that much. But it could be, I reckon it's either Austria, Slovenia or Serbia. Which doesn't really help because we need to pick up some points here. But I know these bollards are, I know Austria and Slovenia use the same bollards, but I'm not sure if Serbia do use the exact same ones or if they're very similar. Again, I'm not 100% on bollards. I know a few, but I don't know all of them. And that goes with poles as well. If I had to say, I'm going to rule out Slovenia. It doesn't look quite Slovenian for me. I don't know, but these trees don't remind me of Slovenia. So it's either, you see, if it was going to be Serbia, it would be far south. I don't think it's far south, so I'm going to guess like far south in Austria. Maybe there's a hedge to go for Slovenia here. It was Slovenia, just over the border. That's perfect, 28 miles away. Very good guess. We got the slightly wrong country, but I knew it was either Austria, Slovenia or Serbia. So kind of rolled out Serbia in my head there because it didn't quite look like Serbia, but to be fair, it didn't look very Slovenian. But I knew it had to be either that or Austria, really. So this should be Netherlands. We have yellow plates everywhere. It doesn't quite remind me of Amsterdam, but it probably will be now in my look. I'm kind of think of The Hague here. It's a bit rogue, but I'm going to go there because it doesn't quite remind me of Amsterdam. It wasn't Amsterdam. It was Tilburg. So yeah, not bad. Glad I got in The Hague there because it's a bit better points wise. Yeah, said so didn't quite feel that Amsterdam to me, but again, not bad. Unfortunately, those first two rounds are a little bit better. Yeah, it would be better. But still, on for a decent score considering we are on harsher scores here with these maps. Okay, should this be Italy then? We have blue on both sides there. No, this is France. So this is probably a very mountainous part of France, probably the Alps or something. So it's got to be Eastern France, next to Switzerland or something. Unless I'm missing out here. French, Alps looking. Is it Switzerland? Is it Switzerland before we start screwing at me? I don't think so. We have Gen 4. Well, we don't have the wide blur. We don't have the low cam. So it has to be France. And also with that normal plate, it has to be French. Probably like, I don't know. Oh, Chambry, was that? Hang on. I thought I saw Chambry on. Okay, close enough. I'm going to guess somewhere here. It was right on the border with Switzerland, but it was France. It was France. That's all that matters. Well, I say all that matters. If I guess a little bit closer to Switzerland, would have got more points there. But yeah, not a bad first game. Considering the first two rounds were a little bit of a miss, those number plates did bite me, to be fair. Especially in the first round. I can forgive myself for that one. That I couldn't see any red plates at all. But the last three rounds were very good. So we got nearly 19k. So that's not bad. Hopefully we can only get better from here and get a decent average. Well, I'd say decent. I'll get a very good average, actually, for this map. Because I reckon Europe is probably one of my stronger continents. So, yeah, on to the next game and see how we do. Oh, and I'll also show you the average score at the end when I've calculated all. So, yeah. Yeah, hopefully you do like this new mini-series concept, this new video concept. Yeah, I think it's quite a decent idea to come up with. And let me know in the next what you want to see in the next video as well, because obviously I could do another one of these continent videos, but also I want to mix up as well. So yeah, let me know. See, I'd love to know what you guys think of this. But anyway, this should be UK or Ireland. We have English, and we're driving on the left. It would really help if you saw any back plates, but we don't. So. Why blur? I guess you see that in both countries, so that doesn't really help. I guess... Doesn't look very Irish, that building, does it? I will guess UK. I'm not sure where to go, though. I'm not sure. Is it Scotland, or is it Northern England? Or is it Southern England? Or is it Wales? Who knows? Who knows? Considering I'm from the UK, I'm not exactly a UK expert when it comes to GeoGuessr, really. In terms of architecture, especially. Not really that great with it, to be honest. Look weird trees, aren't they? Look almost Australian looking. Okay, is that yellow sticker on the pole? Maybe that's more of it. I think that's more of a UK thing, but don't hold me to that. Looks more northern. I'm gonna go for up here. Yes, come on, thank God for that. Looked more northern. Get in. Right, I'm glad I got that. It was just underneath the border for Scotland, so it was just in England. Near Haggerston. Yeah, so I'm glad it figured that out in the end. Not bad to start off with. And we don't have any use strip there, I don't think. Oh, language. Thank you very much. That's weird. That's weird. French? Honestly, don't know. The architecture kinda would make sense for France, but don't, God, this is weird. Well, I've got to think about it. We don't have any new strip. What is this language? Oh, I'm trying to figure out what this language is. I can't tell. This very much screwing me up. Skuole. Voya Bell Skuole. Is that Voya in English? I don't know. This is definitely not UK. Let's close down that because I'm not only that messing me up. Right, I'm gonna guess. Honestly, I think it's like France or Italy, to be honest. Maybe guess somewhere here because it does look very mountainous and it does get mountainous up here near the Alps. It was Italy, not great points wise, but I'm glad I've got the right country. That language did look a bit weird to me, but I guess, you know, hindsight, yeah, it does look quite Italian, but still quite weird. But yeah, thought it'd be more northern considering how mountainous it was. Okay, nice. We have a Czech and Slovakian bollards. That helps a lot. Or do we? Those look like offshoring things you get on the poles. Hang on a minute, let's look at that bollard again. I'd probably trust that actually over the bollard, but those look like checking fucking bollards to me though. Oh, game, why'd you have to do this? Why'd you have to put in this dilemma? Yeah, you see this in Austria. So it's gotta be a flat part of Austria that's near Czechia. It has to be. Like Linz or something. Is it quite flat over here? I guess it is. Has to be there. Unless I'm getting that mixed up in my head, that he's an Austrian Ballard, but that looked Czech and Slovakian to me. Czech and Slovakian, not Czech and Slovakia, Czech and Slovakian. yeah, because I use the same Ballards, so yeah, I probably would. That you do see that in Austria, not anywhere else. So we'll guess there. Slovakia, what? Okay. Well, you learn something new every day. Let me know if you would have got baited by that, or if you would have got at least confused by that, because I know you get red and white stickers and colours on the poles. But maybe I should have trusted the Ballard more, but since I thought maybe, you know, we'd have similar looking Ballards if we was near the border. It was Slovakia. Not bad, not bad. Considering I was a bit confused there. Can't quite tell what language this is. Is it Italian? Don't know what's it like that. yes, it is. It is. It is. Okay, we're getting a lot of Italy rounds. Looks more southern again, doesn't it? With the palm trees. Now, is it in Sicily this time, or is it just on the mainland? I reckon it's probably like somewhere like Catanzaro. Catanzaro. Let's go there. Okay, again, not bad. I swear, if this was on a diver as well or something, we'd be getting great scores here. But yeah, it, as I said, a bit harsher considering on a continental map. But again, on for a decent score. Nothing like spectacular, but decent. Very, very good. Obviously, most of these rounds, we can't really 5K. We could 5K this, but I don't have enough clues. We can't move either. So this is southern, okay, this is southern UK, that helps. There's Swindon, which is basically to the north, because we're going that way, so, like north, hang on, let's zoom out a bit, that would actually help. Yeah, northwest, north, northwest. So there's Swindon, there's Salisbury, and Salisbury is to the west, yeah. No, wait, hang on. I had an absolute mind blank here. South, sorry, south. I don't know why, what happened there. I did have a nap not long ago, so yeah, that might be it. yeah, we're not gonna 5K this, but we can get close. I'm taking forever to try and find this though. So Salisbury to the south. Maybe like we're in Warminster. Three horseshoes, can we quickly find that? No, I'm just gonna guess Warminster. We've gotta be close. Yeah, that's only 24 miles away. So if we zoom out a bit, so yeah, okay, that's fine. We were in Burbage. Well, we didn't wanna zoom in that far. There's the White Hart, yeah, okay. Might have had a little bit more time, I could have found that, but not to worry. 17.7k, so a little bit worse than the last game, but still a decent game. Hopefully in the last game we can try and bump that average off a bit more though, because I feel like I could have done better in this so far. Right, on to the last game. Hopefully this will be our best game yet. I feel like I have played good, but I could be doing better. You know me, I'm quite high standards, but no, I could try and be getting, I should be getting 20k at least one game. Okay, this should be Netherlands. We did have the yellow plate, but I wanted to check if it wasn't Denmark. Because you can get yellow plates in Denmark as well. We should just be in Netherlands here. Couldn't really tell you where though. Again, doesn't look quite like Amsterdam. So we've got guaranteed decent points. Netherlands is small. Oh God, is it like safe like Eindhoven, or is it more like Zwol? Zwolle. Doesn't quite remind me of Zwolle. I suppose the architecture looks a bit more Belgian. I guess, like, yeah, it doesn't. I would say this is further south, because it reminds me of Belgium a little bit. Let's go there. Wow. Maybe that wasn't right. That was all the way up in near Groningen. Yeah, I missed that one. Getting the right country there wasn't really that impressive. Well, this should be Austria. Yeah, .at. German. Is that Belgian number plate? Looks quite red there. Doesn't look like Vienna. Looks more like Innsbruck, but not quite Innsbruck. So more in that area, basically. Could be Innsbruck, actually. Because he's very mountainous. This is very... Yeah, we are in the Alps here. Could be Innsbruck. Not my best bet. Could be a bit more further out here, possibly. I can't see it being over here, but maybe. I'll just guess Innsbruck, because if it is Innsbruck, then I'll get a really, really good score. If it's not Innsbruck, and I'll guess a bit further out here when I didn't need to, I'm going to lose out some points, and yeah, it's going to be a bit annoying. So let's just go Innsbruck. Yeah, it doesn't quite look like Innsbruck, was it? But I kind of just had to go for it, really. Gudmundsen or something, something like that. I'm not even going to bother anymore. In hindsight, didn't feel quite that mountainous to that Innsbruck looks like. So again, I'm just not, I'm playing well, but not quite well enough. Okay, this is Switzerland. We have the lower cam and we have Lugano to east. Hang on. Yeah, to our east. Okay, because we are driving on the left. What? Hang on. No, okay. So I thought this was like a motorway or dual carriage, or motorway or something, or dual carriageway. It looked like we were driving on the left. But no, we're not. We're driving on the right. That'll drive on the left. This will drop, right, okay, wasting time. But yeah, you know what I mean? That did look quite confusing. It looked like we're on the left in Switzerland, which would have been very, very confusing. So Lugano is to our east. So either we're over here near Matterhorn Mountain, or we just look like up here or something. Maybe if we guess like right here. The hedges. Let's pick a row going like west to east. We're gonna have time to, this time limit's really screwing me because I'm not used to the time limit. This fits more. Let's go there. You've got to be kidding me. Oh, okay, we're all way up here. I just thought it looked very far south, but yeah, maybe not. Maybe I should have paid attention to how far we were on that sign. But I couldn't really make out the measurements and stuff on the sign. Still, decent points. Switzerland's a small country, but again, just not quite. I'm playing well, but I'm not quite hitting top form. I'm just not. To be fair, a lot of stuff is baiting me, actually. I kind of will admit that. Right. What bus stops that? Is this? We are driving on the right. Okay, let's try and figure out if we're driving the left or right. So if we're driving on the right, we are in Denmark. Yes, I kind of had a feeling because it looked quite British looking with the architecture, but it wasn't. We're driving on the right. So veg. Not sure exactly how you say it. That means street or road in something like that in Denmark. You say that all the time on signs. So that's how I know when I see that they ending. Or they were, then I know where we are in Denmark. Where in Denmark, again, couldn't tell you, but again, small country, so we're not going to lose it too many points. Not really Denmark expert. Let's go out dense. Near Copenhagen, makes sense. Maybe I should have hedged towards Copenhagen there. But not to worry, because I'm not guessing in the right bloody part of the country. Most of these rounds, not guessing in the right part. So, yeah, I guess in this last round we can keep up with that, can't we? Right, this is Sweden. We're in Sweden, again, nothing to give it away. I knew that because the short white dashed lines on the side of the road, it looks quite Scandinavian with the trees. So, we're in Sweden. Where in bloody Sweden? I'm not really an expert on exactly like where Gen 2 coverage is, where Gen 3, where Gen 4 is. You know, I'm not really the, you know, I don't remember that sort of stuff. Or maybe I would remember if I knew it, but I don't know it, so yeah. Right. Looks a bit more northern to me. But then again, it's probably gonna be more far safe. So if I say that, so maybe it looks more far safe. So we should be further north, right? Right. Hopefully that'll work. Please, GeoGuessr gods. Let's just go there. Okay, that's decent. I will take that. Yeah, that's not bad. Kind of just look like in the middle of Sweden, to be honest. So yeah, decent. That's our best game yet. Not quite 20k, unfortunately. But as I said, I feel like in some ways these maps are actually harder because, as I said, the points are a lot harsher. So it is a lot harder to get 4Ks and a lot harder to get 20Ks. 4Ks on each round, you know what I mean? Yeah, it is a lot harder. The points are a lot harsher. So in a way, I do kind of find these maps a little bit more tougher. Especially on Europe as well, when Europe doesn't have many outstanding meta clues. So for example, when I do Africa, that might be a little bit easier because there's a lot of Google car meta clues in Africa. So that might be an easier map to do. And I might get my highest points on there. Doesn't mean necessarily I'm actually better at Africa. It's just there's a lot of, you know, Google car meta. So that might help with Africa. Just thinking. That's not bad. I played well. I could play a bit better. I did get baited by a couple of things. But yeah, to be fair, I was quite a bit unlucky in a couple of the rounds. Yeah, and also maybe if I get a poor score on one of the maps, so for example, if I'm not satisfied with Europe score, at the end of the series when I've done all the all different continents, I can maybe go back and try and beat a score or two on some of the maps. So yeah, that'd be quite interesting. Right, so that's the average score. I thought I'd kind of just show it here on the calculator. So yeah, it's basically 18,792. So that'll be noted down. And as I said, at the end of this series, when I've completed all the maps for all different continents, we'll see which was my high score. So I reckon that's a decent start. Nothing spectacular, but a very, very solid start. And that's the thing. If I'm not satisfied with this Europe score, I can't see me being very satisfied with like North and South America, because North America will be quite hard because US and Canada look quite similar in some aspects. Very big countries. Yeah, I reckon that North America map might be quite difficult if I'm not on it. And the South America map, hit and miss. I reckon I'm quite hit and miss with South America. So yeah, that will conclude this video. Hopefully you did enjoy, and in the description of each episode, each video of this series, I'll have the average score down for each of the maps that are complete. So it's a bit easy to keep track of the scores, basically. Probably will be doing distance battle royale possibly soon. Might do another sporker quiz, or might do more play-alongs, because to be fair, the play-alongs do quite well. And it gives you guys interacted, so maybe we need to do them a bit more often. So I might do that in the next video. Might get back to the Fun With Flags map, because I've done that very well in that last time. Or I might do another daily challenge. That didn't need such a dramatic thing there. But yeah, hope you did enjoy, and I'll see you for the next video very soon, in a bit.